My journey to the circle has been full of ups and downs, highs and lows, mountains and valleys, which I believe is just a part of life. We grow in the valley. And it's all led me to this space of maturing in my gift. I'm Tasha Cobbs Leonard, and this is my Opry debut.
Yeah, let's go. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Break Every Chain. Break Every Chain is my baby. This song, people ask me all the time, Tasha, do you get tired of singing Break Every Chain? Never. Literally, there is a different response, a different feeling every single time.
Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
I grew up in a small town, Jessup, Georgia. It's in Southeast Georgia on the coast. In a church family, my father, he started pastoring when I was 10 years old. Before that, we were in a family church. My grandmother, my grandfather was the chairman deacon. My grandmother was the church secretary. So just surrounded by a family of believers. I taught my first sermon in church when I was 10 years old. It probably didn't make any sense, but it was a training ground, you know, helping me to get over the nerves of standing in front of a crowd.
Break every chain, break every
Some of the backstory from Break Every Chain is that I was actually driving home from an event and Break Every Chain came on. Well, during that season, I was in a season of depression, really dark days where, you know, I would inspire people, minister hope to people, and go home for days in the dark, struggling with rejection and anxiety and all of these fears. And I remember hearing this song, just crying tears. It was tears of hope. So when I sing that song, I minister it from a place of personal testimony, that I know what this song did for me. I have a team of people who have been with me for years. You don't go as far as your dream, you go as far as your team. Listen, I believe in relationship, you know, and they're here. My husband is my producer, he's my pastor, he's my best friend, super supporter, and so he's gonna be on the keys on the stage. How incredible is that?
I'm really, really honored to be able to be here and share this moment with her. Most people don't know this. I knew Tasha before she had her first record. And so her being a superstar is something I have to kind of remember, because that's just Tasha, my friend.
I recorded a project in 2020 called Royalty at the Ryman, and literally it was during the pandemic, so the room was completely empty. And I remember my label asking me, hey, do you want to move forward with this? And my answer was yes, that I really want our children 10, 20 years down the road to see, man, the church wasn't silent. And it was also a very dark season for my husband and I. We had gone through IVF and lost a baby about 3 days prior to coming to Nashville. And so I was really torn about my faith. There were not very many things that I could hear or very many things that I was certain about in that season, but I really know for a fact that God told me to continue and to move forward with doing that, and that he would give me strength every step of the way.
To be able to share this milestone again on the stage is just incredible. I mean, I remember us talking about, more than anything, wanting to be able to share the gospel and in places that are uncommon, and we believe that's a part of our purpose. And to be able to do it together makes it even more exciting.
When people hear my music, the first thing I want them to feel is inspired. The second thing is I want them to hear transparency. There are several different songs on different albums where you can hear, oh man, Tasha was really going through in that season, and I'm grateful that she didn't keep that from us in her music.
Y'all please make welcome Tasha Cobbs Leonard.